Hey everyone, I'm Anna Huthmaker with Huthmaker Violins, and you found another one of our Students Stuck at Home series, little videos we're trying to do to help the students while they're at home and help the teachers while they're trying to do all this digital learning. Today, and actually for the next three videos, we're going to talk about key signatures. It's one of those things that you start covering sometime when you're in orchestra, the first 6 months, first year. I'm going to lay it all out for you so that you understand all about them and that they are a piece of cake for you. Now, the first thing I want you to know is I want you to commit to memory. C major is nothing. Nothing is C major, because that's the one that kind of breaks all the rules. So the rest of them, today we're going to talk about the sharp key signatures. And it can be a little confusing, because here's the deal. This is what you've got. You've got the name of a key signature, and then you've got what's in it. And since they're all the same letters, you know, everything in music comes down to these letters, A, B, C, D, E, F, G. It can get a little confusing. But if you separate in your brain, we've got the name of the key signature, and then we've got what's living in it. And there are certain rules that are going to make your life so easy. For instance, if there is one sharp in a key signature, it will always, forever and ever and ever, amen, be F sharp. It will never be anything else. Always. If there's two sharps, they will always be F sharp and C sharp. Period. So once you kind of understand that, this makes it a little easier, because your knowledge is going to kind of stack up on each other. Another thing I want you to know, you will never, ever, ever have a key signature with a sharp and a flat. You're either going to have sharps, or you're going to have flats, or you're going to have nothing. And what was that key signature? The name is C major, and it has nothing in it. If a teacher ever says, what's in C major, you can get fancy and say, no sharps, no flats, or you can just say nothing. That is totally the correct answer. Now, if you will learn a couple of little tips and tricks, this is gonna help you with everything. The first thing I want you to learn is the order of the sharps. Now, I've written them up here. The age-old sentence that we always used to learn to memorize it is, fat cows graze daily, always eating butter. Now, the idea of a big old fat cow in a green field eating a big old stick of butter is a little strange, but if it helps you remember the order of the sharps, it's okay. F, C, G, D, A, E, B. So it's really interesting. Remember what I just said a second ago? If we have a key signature that's just got one sharp in it, it will always be the first one, period. If we have a key signature with two sharps, it will always be the first one and the second one. It's never going to be mixed up. It's never going to be start with a B or an A. Always one sharp. If it's two sharps, one and two. One, two, and three. All the way down to seven sharps. Now, the cool thing is, in music, you're always going to know what is either the name of the key signature or what's in the key signature. If you're looking at a piece of music, what's in the key signature is right there on the side of the piece of paper. If you're taking a test, maybe your teacher will tell you the name. They'll say the name is A major, what's in it? The cool thing is, if you know the name, all you've got to do is say the sharps in order until you go right under the name, and that will tell you what's in it. For instance, let's talk about A major. I love A major. Do you know what note is right under an A? It's a G sharp. So if I know I'm in A major, I'm going to say the sharps, F sharp, C sharp, G sharp. I'm going to say them until I get right under that name. That tells me, what's in it. Once you know that name, you just say the sharps in order. Now, what if it's backwards? What if I tell you, oh, five sharps? Okay, five sharps is F sharp, C sharp, G sharp, D sharp, A sharp. Well, if I know what's in it, I go to the very last sharp and I swoop up a half step. I like the swoop. The swoop is important. If I have F sharp, C sharp, G sharp, D sharp, and A sharp, what happens when I swoop up from an A sharp? What do I land on? I land on a B. I'm in the key signature of B major. Now, it's important to always use the word major, and it's important to always capitalize the M in majors. We'll talk about why later on. But do you understand now that if you learn the order of the sharps, and if you learn these two tricks, I know the name, I can figure out what's in it. I know what's in it, I can figure out the name. Then before you know it, your sharp keys, you'll know them all. One little sight reading tip, if you're ever lucky enough to have a sight reading with seven sharps, piece of cake, just sharp every single note. That's the easiest one of all. I'm Anna Huthmaker with Huthmaker Violins, and I hope that this really helped you with your sharp keys. Next time you email your teacher, tell them thank you.